How do ambulances know where to go? Once the caller's location is established by a GPS point, a verbally given address or description, or by the address tied to a landline phone, the ambulance needs to be on its way. Some ambulances use publicly available tools, such as Google Maps or Waze, while others in some places still use paper maps and intuition. None of these are ideal, even Google Maps. It might be tempting to think of Google Maps as a one-size-fits-all navigation tool. And while it's generally reliable and sure beats a paper map and a hunch, it's not always the best fit for emergency services. First of all, Google Maps assumes that all drivers must obey the law. While this is true for the majority of vehicles, emergency services can be exempt from this. For example, many cities have one-way streets. Google would find itself in hot water if it recommended drivers to drive the wrong way up a one-way street. Whereas for an ambulance, it just might be critical that it does. Ambulances can also speed, ignore stop signs, and make illegal turns when necessary. Google, therefore, might not provide an ambulance with the best route. Most dispatchers do not have one lone ambulance, but rather a fleet. While Google Maps allows for groups to be created to view the position of other vehicles, this was built for road trips, not life and death situations. Enter fleet management. Professional software would not only show the location of each ambulance at all times, but also note which ones are undergoing maintenance or are understaffed. Such a software would be able to show the best ambulance for the call. If there are two ambulances, each 10 miles away from the caller, it would take time in Google Maps to determine which ambulance would take less time. Time that is precious in an emergency situation. A professional software would immediately send the ambulance that would arrive in the least amount of time. Not all maps show everything. If they did, they would be so cluttered with information that nothing could be made of them. For example, someone who drives does not need to know the bus routes, but does need to know where there might be an accident. Google Maps does not show certain pieces of information because they are irrelevant to the general public. Irrelevant, except perhaps in an emergency situation. Storm sewage outflow pipes and even manhole covers can have numbers on them that are not on Google Maps, but are carefully detailed in the database of the emergency services. If GPS is proving inaccurate, a caller can say they are next to outflow pipe 21, and the ambulance will know exactly where the emergency is. A piece of more advanced software will also allow an agency to customize areas that need to be customized. For example, Indian reserves and reservations often do not have proper addressing. But in a customized system, an agency can develop their own way of identifying locations in these peculiar areas. Finally, Google Maps is full of third-party and user-generated information. This is useful if a new restaurant pops up on the block. But many have had the experience of going to a place on Google Maps that simply doesn't exist or is moved, but was not updated to reflect that in the database. The amount of data being added by a variety of sources amid the sheer global scale of Google Maps makes it impossible for all the data to be vetted. Ultimately, Google Maps is a great tool with broad applications, but in matters of life and death, it's not always ideal. And until next time, thanks for watching.